Welcome to my lecture. Today we are going to see how to find out range of speed of the Proel governor. Let me read the problem. A Proel governor has equal arms of length 300 mm. The upper and lower ends of the arms are pivoted on the axis of the governor. The extension arms of the lower links are each 80 mm long and parallel to the axis. When the radius of rotation of the balls are 150 mm and 200 mm. The mass of each ball is 10 kg and the mass of the central load is 100 kg. Determine the range of speed of the governor. Here we are provided with two different radius. One is 150 mm, another one is 200 mm. Okay. One is corresponding to the minimum speed of the governor and another one is corresponding to the maximum speed of the governor. Let us see what are all the given data. So, the first thing is the upper and lower length of the arms. So, both are equal. They are 300 mm and the extension arms of the lower links are 80 mm. So, the value of PF is 80 mm. M value is 10 kg, that is mass of the ball, and capital M is 100 kg and it is the central load which is attached to the sleeve. R1, that is corresponding to the minimum speed, which is 150 mm. R2, which is corresponding to maximum speed, which is 200 mm. Now let us see how to draw the configuration. First one corresponding to the minimum speed. We have taken N1 as minimum speed and the corresponding radius of rotation is 150 mm. The configuration is here. This is the upper arm length 300 mm and this is lower arm length. Both are equal in magnitude and this vertical link length is 80 mm. And the mass of the ball is 10 kg and the sleeve mass is 100 kg. Capital M value is 100 kg. Since we have considered the half cross section of that governor, we have taken half of the central load. Okay, that is why mg divided by 2 is put here. Fine. And the h1 value is the distance between this point P to the point F, and it is mentioned as h1. And now let us see the configuration for the maximum speed. Okay, and the maximum speed value is taken as N2 and it is obtained when R2 value is 200 mm, and this is the configuration for the maximum speed of the governor. And here the only difference is the radius of rotation. Here it is 150 mm which is corresponding to minimum speed and here it is 200 mm which is corresponding to maximum speed. Now let us solve the problem. And this is the configuration corresponding to the minimum speed of the governor. And here the upper arm and lower arm length are equal. And both the upper and lower arms are pivoted to the central axis of the governor. So alpha value is equal to beta. So Q value is equal to 1. So now let us see how to find out the h1 value. Okay, so this is the h1 value and the height of the governor for the minimum speed configuration. And h1 value is calculated by using Pythagoras theorem, and h1 value is equal to root of 300 square minus 150 square, and this value is 260 mm. We have to convert that into meter, so it is 0.26 meter. Okay, while substituting this value in the formula to find out the speed of the governor, we have to substitute all the values in meter. That is why we are doing this conversion. So now let us see how to find out these two values, that is the length FM and PM. Okay, the first length is FM and PM. So as far as this problem is concerned, since alpha is equal to beta, this length FM is equal to GD and GD is equal to this H1. Both upper and lower arms are having same length and they are pivoted to the axis of the governor, and hence alpha is equal to beta. So this height will be equal to this height, that means GD. GD is equal to FM. So straight away I am just putting this value as 0.26 meter. Now we have to calculate the PM value. PM value is here, PM. So PM value is equal to FM plus PF. Okay. So by adding 80, I can get that distance PM. PM value is equal to 340 mm. This is equal to 0.34 meter. So now we have calculated all those values which are required to find out the speed of the governor. So this is the formula to calculate the speed of the governor if Q value is equal to 1. Okay. So N1 square is equal to FM divided by PM, M plus capital M divided by M multiplied by 895 divided by H1. We are going to substitute all those values here. FM is 0.26 and PM is 0.34. And small m, that is mass of the ball, is 10 kg, and capital M, mass of the central load, is 100 kg, and again the mass of the ball is 10 kg, and here H1 value is already been found, which is 0.26. okay, after substituting all those value, we have got that N1 value was 170 rpm. So this is the minimum speed of the given governor. Now let us see how to find out the maximum speed of the governor. Okay, so this is the configuration corresponding to the maximum speed of the governor, because the radius of rotation is 200 mm. So first let us see how to find out the H2. So H2 value can be found by using Pythagoras theorem, so which is equal to root of 300 square minus 200 square, and that value is 224 mm. We can convert that into meter, that is 0.224 meter. Okay. And next we have to calculate this FM value as well as PM value. FM value is equal to the height of the governor, because alpha value is equal to beta, and both the upper arm and lower arms measuring same length. So I'm going to write down the same value H2 here. Okay, so both are equal, so the FM value is 0.224 meter. And the PM value can be found by adding this distance, that is 80 mm, with the FM. So the PM value is equal to 304 mm. So it is going to be 0.304 meter. Okay. Now let us see how to find out the maximum speed of the governor. Okay. So N2 square is FM divided by PM, M plus M divided by M, 895 divided by H2. So I am just going to substitute all those value in this equation. So I just got that N2 value was 180 rpm. The range of speed of governor is the difference between the maximum speed to the minimum speed. So that is the thing I'm just going to calculate now. So range of speed is N2 minus N1, which is 180 minus 170. So the range of speed is 10 rpm. Thank you.